In this lecture, we are going to learn about equivalence partitioning. So first we will talk about equivalence partitioning, what it is. So let's try to understand that. Equivalence partitioning divides data into partitions. So you will get a complete data. That data you have to divide. And each of that partition is known as equivalence classes. And you have to divide data in such a way that all the members of a given partition are expected to be processed in the same way. What does that mean? Suppose you have a complete data. Then what you have to do is you have to divide them. You have to make partitions out of it. So suppose we have made four partitions. And each of these partitions is known as equivalence classes. The next what they are saying here is, if you take any data from class 1, then the behavior will be similar. If you take any data from class 3, then also the behavior will be similar to the data which are there in class 3. Though the behavior of data in class 1 and behavior of data in class 2 may differ, but if you take data from the same class, the behavior will be same. So this is what they are telling. And that we will also see in the example. Before going to the example, let's see some more important points. So there are equivalence partitions for both valid and invalid values. So we can provide equivalence classes for the valid value as well as for the invalid values. Let's see what is the meaning of valid value first. Valid values are the values that should be accepted by the component or system. So all the values which system is able to accept is known as valid values, and the partition will be known as valid equivalence partition or valid equivalence class. Similarly, for the invalid value, invalid values are the values that should be rejected by the components or system. So if a system is not accepting some values, then that will be called as a invalid value. And the class will be called as invalid equivalence partition. So this is about valid equivalence partition and this is about invalid equivalence partition. Before going to the example, let's see some more points here. Any partition may be divided into sub-partition if required. So if you have a valid partition, further you can divide it. And then that will be called as sub-partition. Similarly for the invalid values also. The fourth point is, each value must belong to one and only one equivalence partition. When you are writing the test case and while selecting the data, since you have already divided between the valid and invalid and different partitions, you need to select only one data from one partition. This is what they are saying here. The next one is, when invalid equivalence partitions are used in the test cases, they should be tested individually. Suppose there are 3 or 4 different individual invalid classes, then you have to select data from each individual classes. And this also we will see in an example now. So here we will discuss the example and what your task is to understand this example. Suppose this is the requirement which is given to you. System shall accept only 2-digit numbers. So this is a requirement. For this requirement, we can draw a diagram like this. So the smallest 2-digit number is 10 and the largest 2-digit number is 99. And that is why I am using these two as a boundary. So here it's 10 and here it's 99. All the values below 10 will be called as invalid. All the values after 99 will also be called as invalid. Whereas the values between 10 and 99 will be called as valid values. So this is a valid reason. So it is also called as valid equivalence class. And you can take any values including 10 and 99 and all the values between them. They will behave the similar way. The system will accept those values. And that is the reason we are calling it as a valid values. Now if we come to the left side of 10, here we will see these are the invalid values or the invalid class, because 3, 6 and 9 are not 2 digit numbers and this will not be accepted by the system. Similarly, if you come to the right hand side, that is after 99, that is also an invalid portion, but here the digits are 3 digit numbers. So these digits also will not be accepted by the system. And this is how you have to draw the equivalence classes. Now while writing the test case, you have to take value from each of these classes. So from here you can take 6, from here you can take 15, and from here you can take 209. It is up to you. If you take two values like 47 and 93 from here, they both will behave the same way. So it is of no use to write two test cases for them. So this is what equivalence class is all about. And with this, I'm ending this lecture and I will see you with the other topic. Until then, happy testing.